the shadow of Ground Zero, not more than 200 feet from here. Right here we have a, some people came down here with some pamphlets and signs. We're going to talk to one of them right now. Sure.
I'm a long-term resident of the city of New York. Proposed mosque, and you have Ground Zero. Not only I was outraged, but I was incensed and insulted by the sheer uncivilized, I would say, suggestion by people who want to do that. So I dedicated my time now I can to come here to protest.
Okay, so you feel that this is kind of
they're gonna do it, I would be the first person to tell the police that they are the wrong. They did kill him. Many Muslims have been lied in that thing, and many Muslims have been lied.
Sometimes you can't. families, the victims that died because of 19 Muslim hijackers that took planes into buildings right over there, are not upset. I mean, that's a cemetery over there.
The thing is that
it's a cemetery.
If those families want to blame the entire religion, can you still let those 19 people?
Okay, can I stop you? I can't agree with that analogy because Oklahoma, you can build whatever kind of place of worship you want. What if we decided to build a Christian church in Saudi Arabia? What would happen?
Well, okay, so this...
You know what I mean?
I understand what you're saying, but we are in America, not Saudi Arabia, and America is founded on freedom of religion. You know, that's why.
Funny that.
You know, be free to practice your religion. And then, oh, you can't build a mosque here. I mean, as it's a mosque. It's not, it's a peaceful place.
It's a worship.
Okay, and I appreciate people who feel that way.
Yeah.
But my thing is, the question is,
the guy who owned the property in the building just said that it's not open.
I don't know that.
Yeah, I mean,
but do you know this for a fact that it did open on September 11th?
It's documented. That's what it's going to
be. Where it's documented? I mean, you just heard from the gentleman, you know, that it's untrue. So, I mean,
yeah, but
please.
I also hear that Islam is a peaceful religion.
And
that's true.
And the question is.
And that's true.
I guess it's true. It's peaceful. It is peaceful.
500 yards that way, two towers are down, 3,000 people died at the hands of what?
Okay, tell me something, you know, I have to go back to, say, 40, 45 years ago, you know. Who was Hitler? Remember, you know, so,
well, he was born as a Christian, so he killed, you know, millions of millions. He killed millions of people, so is that now the whole Christian religion is bad? No, of course not. I mean, you can't blame a religion for 19 people.
KKK meeting or something. That might work better for
what,
that.
This one?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So you're going to come with me?
No, you're going to go. Not with me.
Is that what you believe?
Oh, no. I believe.
You think that I'm a racist? That I belong with KKK?
I think the evidence is clear, sir. Have a beautiful day.
You too. Have a wonderful day. Stay cool.
And that's the beauty of this country.
Right.
And that's why we all thank God that we're Americans. But there's a time and a place, and this is not the time and the place. And there's supposed to be proper permits and proper expressions of assembly. Which
is nice to meet you.
Pleasure to meet you.
Entire week interviewing families of the victims of the 9/11 survivors.
Right.
We're working on a documentary film about this mosque being created.
Okay.
So we've been here all week.
That's the beauty of this country.
Right.
That's the beauty of everything that's happened and everything that has defined America first. And that's why you and I can look at each other, we can shake hands, we can smile at one another, and I have no anger or hate or frustration with anything that you're doing. I actually encourage you to do what you're doing, and I commend you for it, because you're taking advantage of your freedoms and your rights as an American.
All right.
So we can talk with each other and laugh, and
absolutely. We can look at each other, and you can have your hopes, and I can have my hopes, but at the end of the day, we can shake hands. they'll have a cup of coffee. Good human beings and good Americans. Please.
What did you tell them about the environment? Okay, they are frozen, they are hurt, they do not want this, slap their face.
You know, I would tell all of them that we, that what happened that day broke my heart more, you know, there's nothing that I could say that could justify that what happened that day, except that it was pure terrorism, okay? It was the worst act of terrorism that ever happened to me as an American, as a New Yorker, as a citizen, and I spent the next 48 hours of my life down there trying to find help, do whatever I could do as an American, as a citizen. And I don't have anything that I could say or you could say or anybody can say to help what they're going through. But the only thing that I can do or that we can do, okay, is to have a dialogue, to educate and to be courteous to one another.